In a world with a variety of men's boots, the Clark's Desert Boot has stood sovereign for 75 years, until another Desert Boot was born, the Desert Boot 2. Will the original Desert Boot stand the test of time, or is it a memento of years past? Find out in this episode of BootSpy.
Thank you so much for joining me. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button down below and also give me a thumbs up. Both are super helpful for the channel and I really appreciate it. So today, as I said, we are covering the Clark's Desert Boot 2 and the Clark's Desert Boot. So I'm gonna cover an overview of both of these boots and then compare them head to head, talk about the main differences, and then give you which one of these two boots is my personal favorite. Starting off with the classic, this is the Clark's Desert Boot Original in beeswax leather. The beeswax, very nice supple leather. This is also available in the Clark's Desert Boot 2, so if you just like the color of this boot, you can find it in both versions. But this boot, iconic look, so many people are wearing this. I bet you if you go out for the next week and look at people's feet, you're gonna see somebody wearing a Clark's Desert Boot. That's how popular this boot is. And it's two eyelet Chukka, and it has this crepe rubber sole, which is super soft, super shock absorbent, and very comfortable to wear around, just like if you stand a lot all day. This is a very comfortable boot. As for the Desert Boot 2, I got this in the dark brown suede. Really like how classic this is, how clean it is, and you can also tell that the sole is a darker brown color rather than that classic cream crepe sole. Now, the Desert Boot has this crepe sole, which has some positives and some negatives. Positives, it's really soft, really squishy, so that when you're standing a lot for a long periods of time, there's a lot of support there and has tons of shock absorption, so your feet don't really get tired. The sole on the Desert Boot 2, also really soft, but a little bit harder. That helps increase its durability, so the abrasion doesn't kind of wear down on the heel so much. So the sole lasts longer. And then the other major difference is that, as you can see, I've worn this a few times, and right here, the sole on the crepe gets really dirty really quickly because it is basically the material of an eraser. It's like pretty close to that. So it really picks up a lot of dirt from the sidewalk. And so it does tend to get very dirty very quickly. And that'll also start to show on the sole. So you won't get this cream color anymore. It'll kind of turn to a dirty gray. You do lose a little bit of shock absorption from the classic Desert Boot. But I think ultimately in the sole perspective, the Desert Boot 2 is a massive improvement with that harder natural rubber sole. Moving to the inside of the Clark's original Desert Boot, there is a heel pad on that insole, and that's meant to offer a little bit of extra support in the heel. But a lot of reviews, and I didn't really experience this myself, but a lot of reviewers said that that actually kind of pinches on the heel of their foot and adds a little bit of discomfort instead of adding the extra comfort that it's meant to. So again, I didn't really experience that, but I did read that in several reviews. Now that has been totally changed with the new Desert Boot 2, where it actually has a removable insole, which I like for a variety of reasons. One, this insole is really, really supportive. It adds a lot of cushion in the ball of your foot and in the heel. And also if you have flat feet or you need extra arch support, it's really easy to take these insoles out and add your own custom insoles in there. So I think this is another massive improvement over the original Clark's Desert Boot. The Desert Boot 2 with this removable insole, it just makes it so much better, so much more versatile comparatively. The final most important change is that the shape of the Desert Boot has changed very, very subtly. So as you can kind of tell, the Desert Boot 2 is about a centimeter taller. That toe box is a lot more structured, and that solves another one of the biggest issues I've had with the Desert Boot. When I'm looking at people wearing Desert Boots, you know, out and about, a lot of times this toe starts to get deflated pretty easily, pretty quickly, and it makes it look more almost like a slipper or something like that. However, with the more structured toe box and the raised profile of the Desert Boot 2, I think that's gonna solve a lot of that issue and ultimately just make this look more like a boot rather than just like this kind of beat up old slipper. In addition to the more structured toe box, Clark's has also gone and made a change that you're not gonna really be able to notice on camera, but basically between these two boots, they've gone ahead and on the new Desert Boot 2, they've narrowed this portion of the boot by about a centimeter and a half. They've also narrowed down the heel. So it's more of a narrow fit on the back end And that kind of gives it a more streamlined, more tailored looking fit. Ultimately, if they're narrowing down the heel, narrowing down the instep, and then adding a little more structure to the toe box, I think that just rounds the shoe out a little bit more and makes this boot a little more versatile in more dressy situations. Here's my final verdict on the Desert Boot versus the Desert Boot 2. Honestly, what drew me to the Desert Boot in the first place is that it's an old, iconic boot. It's 75 years old, and I love the fact that it really stayed true to its roots. So I was skeptical of the Desert Boot 2, changing out that crepe sole, changing the design a little bit. I wasn't sure if I was gonna like it as much because I really liked how like classic and authentic the Desert Boot is. But after wearing both around for quite a while, the Desert Boot 2 is just clearly better, clearly superior. They're both the same price. They're both right around $150. If you wanna check either out, I have links down below in the description. But really, the Desert Boot 2, it solves every problem I had with the Desert Boot, and it's just a way better design. So I'm glad they came out with it. I'm glad Clark's made the second Desert Boot, the next version. It's a great update. I think it's slimmer, more structured toe box, looks like a boot. You can wear it in more dressy situations, and then the sole is going to last longer and look cleaner the whole time too. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up and also hit that subscribe button. Both are super helpful for the channel, and I really, really appreciate it. Until next time, put your best boot forward.